Welcome everybody to hello and welcome everybody to another sculpting session. Again, I will be doing cars, a car base mesh. The base mesh is modeled in scale to according to the wheels and a valid wheelbase. The wheels are 20-inch. Rims and appropriate tire hump. So I'm just gonna start out. First thing I do is flatten the corners off, enable the dynamic, give me a good curve. The curve, I'm just gonna do this. Or something like this. Don't give me a very hard curve to work with. I'm just gonna take off the sharp corners so I get some detail on it. Something wrong here. Oh, just start over again because I'm not going to get there. Oh, correct. I just did. Okay. Okay. Guys, totally cool. Sculpt mode. Whenever you go out of sculpt mode, you have to get in back. You have to get back in. So I'm rounding off the corners here. Okay, cool. So I have another screen open and I just googled Ferrari. So I'm gonna try to go for the Italian design this time. I'll flatten this a bit more. So Ferraris, for the most time, they have this wedge shape. I'm gonna take this down a bit more, but first I'm gonna try to get in to have a good wedge shape. I'm gonna increase my brush size to make it more appealing for me. I'm just using this now. We're applying the alpha so I can see the curve, and I'm working on a bit better. Now I'm working it a bit better. It gives me more of a feeling what I'm doing. Roughing out this corner. Just keeping using the flat brush, trying to get in some I'm trying to have some nice shapes in mind. Can pursue a bit more according to what I think that works for this car. I'm just flattening out stuff. And most of the furries, they have a fairly pointy nose, so I'm gonna put a grease pants in. This is something I want to accentuate a bit more. And here I want to go. Okay, cool. I'm gonna switch to add because I want to add material. Now I'm gonna get the wheel arches out a bit more. Because your wheels are gonna have to have some room to sit in, to turn around. Some material here. And again, I'm going to start flattening stuff out. I'm going to flatten this out. With the flat brush, I use gentle strokes. Okay, so now I'm looking at my reference picture. Starting to get a wedge here. Just hang on there, it's slowing it down my computer a bit. I hope it's not too annoying. Okay. You know, the nose is getting there. I believe this is still too high, so I'm gonna get that down a little bit. Let's see how this looks. Oh, this is terrible. It actually is terrible. I don't have to get in here. Flatten this out. Somewhere. I want to give this car a nice impression of speed. But it's still bump, it's still a huge bump here, so this has to go. Oh my god, my computer's so slow. Okay, I'm just looking at lines here that I can work with. I'm gonna use a car brush. Mark some flatness in. Turn it down. As you can see, where it's white, it's a lot of effects. But I don't want that. I want to have my favorite curve. Still too still too big. I hate it when I can fix slow down as much. So now I'm working on my roof and I want to have some. Ooh, that's big up front, but go smaller to the sides, to the back. This is starting to get somewhere. Okay, cool. Still a bit too big there. Well, I got back to that later. Do something else now. The fun thing about doing sculpts is you can always switch between things you like and you start working on something like I did on the roof. And then you go like, oh no, I don't like it, and you can actually go in hours and hours and just on that roof. But I found out that it's sometimes more sometimes better to start doing something else. And get that out of your mind and then start working on something else, and then you get back with some new fresh ideas on how you're gonna tackle it, and usually it's better to work like that because you will get some more inspiration on how you can work something out, and gonna get some nice results working like that. So I just got in here, scraped something off. I can accentuate that. Get that into the flow of the car. Okay, cool. I'm getting some frozen, I'm getting some curves in my car. I'm just gonna add some material now because here the wheel is, the wheel arch is way off. And I don't want that. I want to have some nice wheel arches. Sometimes my models always look the same. Big things. Oh, there's something cool going on here. By the way, this pops out. I'm gonna pursue that a bit more. So usually give some muscle to the thigh. Working that out. See, that's what I mean. You go in and just work on something else if you're not satisfied with a certain part of your model, and you quickly figure out that okay, this works and this doesn't work, and then you like this and you don't like that. And it's a process. But if you get stuck on one part and don't want, you're not getting the most out of your session. So just like it's like jumping back and forth and seeing, oh, okay, oh, I like this, I like these shapes, I like these lines, and I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna plan them because I think this is something worth pursuing. Got a nice play of lines here. But doing this hangout on air is actually frying my computer. It's no problem. Our density is still good. I don't have these much vertices yet. Actually quite good. That's tough. Okay, cool. I see stuff happening here. Or is it? Yeah, local radio station is having rapid delight. If you hear me singing with Dr. Dre and stuff, feel like it. Here's something not that good. I'm gonna try to come in and extract some material. They're actually pushing stuff back. Scraping things out. I'm gonna stop this fire session for a moment because I'm getting frustrated that my computer is this slow. I'm gonna try to show the finished results of this. If you have any questions, please contact me, no problem. Always glad to help. Goodbye.